morning, everybody. It's 2019. Wish you all a very, very, very happy new year. So it's been almost 6 months. We've been meeting very frequently for our Facebook sessions about IELTS. Don't worry, today's session is not about studying. It is all about celebration. I'm sure you must have had a great night. Welcoming 2019, it was great. It must have been great, I'm sure. So here I am today with a very short and brief session about celebrations. This is also a very common topic in speaking IELTS, in which you have to describe about a party or a festival or celebration. So today I am here just to give you some vocabularies which could eventually increase your bar in your IELTS speaking. So whenever you think of a party, what is the first thing that comes to your mind? For me, it's food, clothes, the place, friends, memories, photographs. So these are some very common things that always strike our mind when we think of a party. So how many of you actually write down these pointers when you have that 1 minute while preparing for your cue card? That is something which you can do. So when you think of a party, think of these six areas, write them down on the sheet of paper and write just one word which could support or provide a good vocabulary as in a lexical resource for that particular segment. Like if I talk about clothes, now there are a lot of vocabularies which could be used in this context. We know the word attire, but we don't use it that often. Why? Of course you can use it. I am looking forward to update my wardrobe because it's my new year resolution. So maybe you're coming up with something new or you want to update your style. So rather than saying update my style, you can say I am planning to update my wardrobe. So updating your wardrobe means maybe following a new style statement, buying something new, bringing a big change when it comes to your dressing sense, right? So you can use words like attire, dressing sense, updating my wardrobe. These are certain words which you can use to describe clothes. Second segment, my favorite, that is food. Now if you remember, and the people who have been following my sessions before, we already have had a very long and elaborated session about food, wherein I discussed a lot of areas. Now here I would describe just two or three vocabularies which can eventually upgrade your score for food. Now there are some common words like I had some regional delicacies last night. So regional is which is pertaining to your own region. Delicacies is used for food. So I had some regional delicacies last night. So delicacies used for delicious food. Regional is used for something pertaining to your own region. So a vocabulary which you can use, the food was mouth-watering. I know it is very commonly used nowadays, but yes, people do use it. So use delicacies rather than delicious food. Okay, now if I talk about food, I'll like go on and on and on. So now let's switch to another segment, which probably is photographs. Now, I clicked. Yes, I am a camera shy person. Generally, I am behind the camera. So someone who clicks the picture, someone who doesn't like getting clicked, you would call that person to be a camera shy, right? So yesterday in the party, I did click many pictures, but since I am camera shy, I was mainly behind the camera. So camera shy, another vocabulary that can be used to describe maybe when photos were clicked during the party. Moving ahead, the entire environment. So you could say that it was very lively. The ambiance was next level. Now ambiance or ambience, both the pronunciations are correct. The spelling is same, but people pronounce it in two different manner. You can you can either call it ambiance or you can call it ambience. Meaning is the aura of that place, right? Was it lively? Was it dull? Was it exciting? Was it fun? So how was the ambiance? How was the feel of that place? So the ambiance of the place was amazing. It was worth enjoying, right? So I started with first clothes. I'm planning to update my wardrobe this year because I think the clothes that I'm wearing, they are outdated now. So I need to change them. Then we move ahead to food. The food last night I had was delicious. I tried some regional delicacies which turned out to be amazing. Since I am camera shy, I did not get clicked, but yet I clicked many pictures. And finally, the ambiance of the place was amazing. I loved that moment and I look for parties over and over again. So these are some very common vocabularies which could be used to describe a party. There are some other list of vocabularies which I would give you in our upcoming classes. But to keep it short and sweet, I am not elaborating it today. I know all of you are in fun mood. It's 1st of January. No one wants to study today. So I've tried to keep it pretty simple. I'll be meeting you guys soon in my next sessions with a whole lot of new vocabularies and each and everything about IELTS examination. It's bye for now. Have a great year, because what you do today, you're gonna do throughout the year. Bye bye and happy new year again.